Today is the 20th day of the blessed month of Thoth. May God end it in goodness and renew it for us, in peace and tranquility, while our sins and iniquities are forgiven through the tender mercies of our Lord. O my fathers and my brethren, amen. On this day, the church commemorates the departure of Saint Theopesta. She was married and had a son. Her husband died while she was still young. She vowed to spend the rest of her life in worship, asceticism, and raising her son in the fear of God. She started to practice the spiritual life. She persevered in fasting, prayers, and kneeling. She went to Abba Macarius, Bishop of Nicias, and asked him to pray on her and put on her the monastic garb. The bishop promised to fulfill her wish after she had tried herself for 1 year. She went to her house and shut herself in a small room. Her son, who was then 12 years old, was taking care of her needs. She embarked in strenuous worship and asceticism and great devotion. The year elapsed, and the bishop had forgotten that he had promised this saint that he would put on her the garb of the monasticism. One night, he saw her in his sleep in a shining figure, telling him, "My father, why did you forget me till now? And I am passing away tonight." The bishop saw that as if he was awake. He prayed on her the prayer of for ordaining monks and put on her the garb of monasticism. When he did not find the clinsaw cover for the head, he took off his own and put it on her head. Then he put on her the holy scheme. She had a silver cross in her hand, which she gave to him, saying, "Accept this cross from your disciple." Immediately the bishop woke up from his sleep and found the cross in his hand, and he looked attentively at the cross, which was beautifully made. He was amazed and glorified God. He went with his disciple to the house of this saint. He found her son sitting beside her room crying. When he asked him why he was crying, he replied, saying, "My mother called me in the middle of the night and bid me farewell, and told me that she is departing tonight to go to the Lord Christ. Then she commanded me, saying, 'Whatever the bishop tells you, do it and do not break it.' Then she departed in peace." When the bishop heard this, he came to the room of the saint and knocked on the door and called on her, but she did not answer. He said, "This blessed saint had departed indeed," and he ordered his disciple to open the door. When the bishop entered, he found that she had already departed. She had on the scheme that he had put on her in his vision, and also the clinsaw that he had on. He realized that what he had seen in his sleep was reality. His eyes were filled with tears. He praised and glorified God, who works out the satisfaction of his saints. The bishop shrouded her by his own hands, as was the custom of the nuns, and ordered to carry her to the holy church, where he prayed over her. There was in the city a paralytic infidel man, suffering from evil spirits. He asked his people to carry him to take him where the body of the saint was. When they brought him to the church, he drew near to the holy body with faith, and he was cured instantly. The devil came out of him and was able to walk well. He and his entire household believed in the Lord Christ, and the bishop baptized them. And everyone who had a disease or a deformity would come to the church and touch the holy body and would be healed. The blessing of her praise be with us all. Amen. On this day also, the year 213 of the martyrs, the blessed Father Abba Athanasius II, 28th Patriarch of the See of St. Mark, departed. This father was the steward of the Church of Alexandria. When Pope Peter III, the 27th Patriarch, departed, the bishops, elders, and people agreed to consecrate to his father, patriarch for what was known of his orthodox faith and piety. He was called Athanasius the Less, to identify him from St. Athanasius the Apostolic, and that was during the reign of Emperor Zeno. This father participated with Emperor Anastasius, who came after Zeno, to re-establish the peace between the churches of the East after being disrupted by the Council of Chalcedon. The time of this pope was peaceful and tranquil. He shepherded his people in purity and righteousness, then departed in peace. He sat on the throne of St. Mark for 7 years. The blessings of his prayers be with us all. Amen. On this day also, the Church celebrates the commemoration of the martyrdom of St. Maltina, the Virgin. The blessings of her prayers be with us all, and glory be to God forever. Amen.